In this screencast, we want to look at how the enthalpy depends on pressure for three situations. One, ideal gas. Two, a real gas. And then three, a liquid. We're interested in, at constant temperature, if I'm going to push down this piston and increase the pressure, what happens to the enthalpy? So let's look at the ideal gas case first. And for ideal gas, there's no interaction between the molecules, so it doesn't matter that they're closer together. We're not changing the enthalpy, and so the enthalpy change for an ideal gas only depends on temperature. If the temperature is constant, delta T is zero, then delta H is zero. Now I'll look at a real gas, and what I'm going to do is use steam at 500 degrees C, so this is actually above the critical temperature, but what we want to show is the dependence on pressure, so we might call this a fluid as opposed to a gas, but molecules clearly interact. So let me show you some values that are taken out of the steam table. You can see here that as we change the pressure, starting at low pressure, and of course, this now going from a tenth of a bar to one bar, almost no change. Even going to 10 bar, very small change here in the enthalpy. At 100 bar, we see a significant change, but it's 100 kilojoules out of 3,500 kilojoules, so very small. When we get to very high pressures, now we see a significant change, the enthalpy decreased as we went to these very high pressures. But if you like a real gas, we're at still 10 bar pressure. Enthalpy is pretty close to ideal gas behavior. We're talking about, you know, a percent, less than a percent change. So the final case, let's look at liquid. And again, I'll pull some data from the steam tables. So here's liquid water. Notice that one bar pressure, the internal energy and enthalpy are almost identical. We go to 5 megapascals, 50 bar pressure. We see a very slight increase in the enthalpy, very slight decrease in internal energy. Notice internal energy decreases as we raise pressure, but enthalpy increases because of the PV term. And so the difference between these two of 100 is due to that pressure volume term because we're at now 1,000 bar pressure. So enthalpy for liquid, except at very high pressures, is also relatively insensitive, like an ideal gas, but for a very different reason. We can't compress a liquid very much, and therefore, we don't change its properties when we raise the pressure. So for an ideal gas, enthalpy was independent of pressure because the molecules don't interact. Clearly, in a liquid, the molecules interact, but now they're densely packed, so we can't change the properties very much except by going to very high pressures.